So since I is equal to 1, that belongs to sigma 0 only. Because for lambda 0, I is equal to 0. Therefore, this is the allowed. So x must be sigma c. So using this result, you have to eliminate. First, using s minus 1 here, this is maybe 4 particles. And since if I using q is equal to 0, it is reduced to 2 particles. Either it may be sigma 0 or lambda 0. Then by using I is equal to 1, this must be only 0. So this must be only sigma c. Now let us take one more problem. 3. P plus P goes to pi plus plus n plus lambda 0 plus some x. So what is x? What is x? Now here again you find q, 1 plus 1, this is 1 plus 0 plus 0 plus q, therefore q must be 1. So the charge of the particle must be 1, and the lepton number 0 plus 0, the meson plus this is 0, 0 plus L, therefore L must be 0, so this is not a lepton. Baryon number, this is 1 plus 1, here baryon is 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus B, therefore B must be, so this is a meson, therefore this is 0. So in the 2, so B must be 0. And S is equal to S is equal to 0 plus 0, this must be 0 plus 0 minus 1 plus S. So S is equal to plus 1. So this is not a lepton, it is not a baryon, means the particle must be meson. So first idea, you get this particle must be meson, so it must be particle within here, and S must be plus 1. S must be plus 1 means the particle may be either k 0 or k plus. So the particle may be either k 0 or k plus, and the charge is must be 1, therefore the charge is plus 1 for this one, since q is equal to 1. Therefore the particle x must be k plus, because this baryon number is 0, lepton number is 0, s must be plus 1, q must be plus 1. So here this x is equal to. So in this way you have to find the missing particle if the particles are allowed. The next is suppose if the particle is given, so some of the questions are asked in previous examinations, and the you are asked to find the quark content of a particle. So in order to find this one, first you write down, draw this one, and you form the table like q, b, and the i3, s, y. I is not required to not required very much, that's why I am not including I here. There are two quarks u d and s quark. The charge is plus 2 by 3 of electronic charge. This is 2 by 3 and this is minus 1 by 3 and this is minus 1 by 3. of the electronic charge.
Here the baryon number, the sum on the combination of three quarks gives one baryon. So one quark will be 1/3 baryon. So the quark baryon number is 1/3 that we have discussed.
And I3 is these two particles belong to a group. So this must be half, this must be minus half. And this is a single particle, so the I3 is 0.
And the strangeness quark number is this will be 0, 0. And this is minus 1. And the Y3 will be 1/3. 1/3 minus 2/3, because there is a, we already discussed, you have drawn the I3 versus Y diagram for the quarks. So this is 1/3 and this is minus 2/3. And this is a half. And from here to here, so up quark, down quark, and this strange quark. So this is your I3 value, and this is your.
So from this, you can write down the Y value as S value.
Now the question is, find the quark content. Find the quark content. Suppose for the particle, suppose if you choose a particle, so the question may be asked like this. Four options may be given, you have to choose the correct one. Now for this, you find Q value, B value, I3 value, S value, and Y value. So since this is a double plus, so Q must be 2, since it is a baryon, B is 1. Since there are 4 particles, therefore I3 will be 3/2. So you can find I is equal to 3/2, and if and Q minus Q bar, that can be also determined. I3, that can be calculated. So we have already discussed how to find I3. And the strangeness number is 0, and this is Y is equal to 1. So delta plus this is a strangeness number is Y minus B, so this is 0, Y is 1. So all the numbers can be written like this. Now from this you have to arrive the quark content. So charge is 2, so you have to choose 3 particles U, D, S. Among these, you have to choose 3 particles, up, down, strange quark, and the 3 particles must satisfy these all the requirements. Since this is a 2 double plus, so it must be 2, the Q must be 2. So Q is 2 is possible, this is 2/3. Another particle must be 2/3. If you choose another here, down or yes, here, since it is a minus value, so the Q value will be decreasing. So the only possibility is 2/3 plus 2/3, 2/3. Then only Q must be 2. So there is no other possibilities. So this must be up, and this must be up, and this must be up. So this quark content is up, up, up. This is a quark content. So sigma plus plus, the quark content is UUU. So if you choose any other value, the charge will be 0. So from this, this number itself, you can check this. You can also easily check this baryon number. This each number is 1/3. Once I have all the 3, this will be 1. And I3 for up quark, down, this is a half, so half plus half plus half, 3/2. Strangeness number Y, this is 1/3, 1/3 plus 1/3 is equal to, so that can be also checked. So this is the important thing. So from this you can get this is a
up quark. Suppose if you choose sigma minus. So sigma minus, so what is the value of q? Minus 1. Baryon number, this is a baryon, this is a 1. I3 value is minus 1. So this is a sigma minus. Sigma minus. I3 is minus 1. And Strange's square number is also minus 1. Y is 0. So from this diagram, you can first write down like this. Then you have to choose 3 numbers which gives minus. So if you choose up quark among 1, then the charge will not be, you cannot get a minus 1 value here. The only possible values are, it may be either SSS or DDD or D, a combination of D and S. So there is a possible, so up quark may be eliminated. Then we have to check the other numbers also. Baryon number is 3, so you need not check the, because there are 3 particles, all particles are identical value B, 1 by 3. So you need not worry about this one. Now go for I3. If you go for I3, suppose if you choose I3 must be 1, minus 1. I3 is minus 1 is possible. If you choose this and this, suppose if you take 2 particles of D and 1 particles of S, you will have minus 1. If you take 1 particle of this, 2 particles of this, you won't get this one. So the only possibility is, this is a DDS. So the DDS, this is the quark content. So now the Q is minus 1 as well as I3 is minus 1. Similarly, you check the other quark numbers. So this is corresponds to DDS. Suppose if you take P, the quark number is 1. And B number is 1, I3 is equal to half, S number is 0, Y number is 1. This is possible only by choosing UUD. If you choosing UUD, 2 by 3 plus 2 by 3 minus 1 by 3 is equal to 1. So charge is satisfied. And also if you choose I3 is equal to for up quark half, so this is I3, and plus half down quark, so this is half, so this is also satisfied. And S number, what is S number? S number, this is 0, for up 0, down is also 0, so S is satisfied. And Y number, 1 by 3 plus 1 by 3 plus 1 1 by 3, so this is equal to 1. Therefore this is a quark content for proton. Now let us find the quark content for omega minus. For omega minus, this is a charge is minus 1, and this is Q is minus 1, baryon is 1, and I3 is 0, strangeness is minus 3, Y is minus 2. So since it is a minus 2, Y is minus 2, minus 2 of minus 1, this is a baryon, therefore S is minus 3. So now here, if you choose S, this is a minus 1 by 3, minus 1 by 3, minus 1 by 3, so the charge is satisfied, and S number is minus 1. So for S quark, it is a minus 1. So S value is equal to minus 1, and this is also minus 1 and minus 1, minus 3. So this is satisfied. And the charge Q is equal to 1 by 3 plus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 3. So this is satisfied. And Y is equal to minus 2. Y must be minus 2. So what is the S quark? Y is equal to minus 2 by 3 minus 2 by 3, which is equal to minus 2. So this is also satisfied, therefore this is yes. So omega minus corresponds to the combination of 3 s squares. So in this way you can determine the quark content of the elementary particle. So in this class we have discussed the type of interaction and strong interaction, electromagnetic interaction, weak interaction, and next we have discussed how to find the missing particle in a reaction if the reaction is allowed, and the third one is how to find the quark content of any particle. So in all the discussions you need these diagrams. So these diagrams as well as this one, if you draw these four diagrams, if you keep all these four diagrams in your mind, you can do all the problems related to the particle physics. So you can easily score, you can get you can write all the questions correctly and get a good score in this particle physics if you remember these diagrams. Basically, instead of memorizing all these quantum numbers, if you draw the diagram, the diagrams can be easily memorized because they are very simple diagrams and the coordinates are also very simple. So from this you can easily obtain all the quantum numbers. So from this you can find the quark content as well as the type of reactions.